Thank you so much for coming down and welcome. So I spent about 20 years living in Zen temples and monasteries and so on, and nearly all of the ones I actually ended up living in had a style of different types, variations of body work associated with them. And so I've been sharing that work over the years, as well as the stillness practices. So let's start in stillness. So if you can come into some kind of uprightness, sitting, kneeling, you can even use a chair if you like. And if you can find the center of your head and line it up with the center of your chest area, the heart area, and line that up with the center of your belly. Okay, what you do with your legs is less important. Don't force anything, please. Let your hands rest in your lap. Let your eyes lower and close. Now, this is where our school of Zen started. It started back in the 8th century with a monk called Basso. He was desperate to find some kind of liberation, some kind of release from his anguish, his suffering. All he felt he could do was sitting in meditation. He sat and sat and sat like this. Now his teacher, Nangaku, seeing how Basso in this was, as it were, still kind of stuck, said to him, "Why are you sitting like this?" Basso says, "I seek to become a Buddha." So Nangaku, the master, picks up a bit of broken tile from the ground and starts to rub it. Basso says to him, "What are you doing?" Nangaku says, "I'm trying to make a mirror." And Basso, the meditator, says, "But how can you make a mirror by polishing a tile?" Nangaku, the master, says, "If I can't make a mirror by polishing a tile, how can you become a Buddha by sitting?" Nangaku carries on. He says, "If you try to sit like a Buddha, you're just killing the Buddha. If you attach to the form of sitting, you will never know the essence." And the old text says that at that point, Basso tastes the blissful nectar of realization. He kind of gets it, that being stuck in any kind of configuration is not it. And so from that time on, our school of Zen became called the Hangzhou School in China, and then went on to Japan, and has emphasized not only stillness, but the dynamic quality of movement. Okay, so now from here, okay, bearing in mind this alignment, your head, your heart, your belly, bearing in mind this centering that we have here, if you'd be willing now to come into a position where, if you can, sitting back onto your heels, and then let the body come forward. So your forehead is down on the floor and your hands down beside you like this. Now, if that's uncomfortable, then please do the opposite, where you have your back down and you're, as it were, hugging your knees. Either is just fine, okay? So whichever position is going to be right for you. So we're in a position where everything's kind of tucked in. Everything's drawn in and together. You're like a seed. You're like an unborn child in this position, okay? Like Basso, before the life begins to spring up, before the movement begins to happen. So in this position, okay, everything drawn in, just again, let your eyes close, let your body relax as much as you can. So this winter season is this time of stillness, when everything is drawn into the center. The Zen, as it were, saying connected with this time is nourishing the root, okay? We're drawing into the center, and then we're gonna, as it were, grow from here. So So just breathing here, letting everything settle, letting everything center, letting everything gather. One more breath. So as we're just going to begin to come out of this now, if you're on your front, just gently come up. If you're on your back, just gently come up. Now, a few kind of principles behind what we're going to be doing. The number one is, please listen to your body. This is a process of, as it were, communicating with your body rather than forcing. Okay? We're not trying to, as it were, the mind impose the will on the body. It's more like a dialogue. Your body actually wants to be open, free, and liberated. We don't have to try to make that happen, but we have to, as it were, work in the way that the body wants. And what the body is wired up on a very deep level to resist is forcing. So please take it gently. Now, anything that you need to adapt in what we're doing, please go right ahead. Just scale things back. Anytime you need to have a little rest, please go right ahead. Totally fine. The scientists tell us, apparently, that if there's a move that you can't do or you feel is inappropriate, if you just imagine it, then apparently you get 80% of the benefits without even moving a muscle. So you can literally lie on your mat and still do the practice, all right? So there's no value, there's no need to force anything. Our process is based in mindfulness, and particularly mindfulness of the body, mindfulness of sensations, which are two of the four ways that the Buddha says are the sort of direct ways to liberation, to enlightenment. So when we say mindfulness of the body and mindfulness of sensations, it's essentially an in-the-moment, non-judgmental presence. We're just with what is, the quality, the texture of what is right now, without any agenda. So we're not trying to actually go anywhere. We're being with what is. And paradoxically, as we do that, that is the gateway to transformation. Okay, so as we go forward, doing your very best to maintain this mindfulness of the body, and mindfulness of sensations, or another way of saying that is mindfulness of what you can feel within the body. Now, another way again of saying that is mindfulness of aliveness, being aware of the life, the energy, the actual sense of what's going on within your body at any moment. So we're going to be exploring on a level which is going to be, as it were, nourishing body and mind over this winter season, and is also going to, as it were, help us come into the place of non-separative or non-dual awareness, the place where we're home, the place where us and the universe are one, the place where, like Basso, we too can taste the blissful nectar of liberation. Okay, so now let's all of us come onto our backs. And before we go into the position, if you take your fingers and find your navel, okay, and then three fingers width below the navel, there's a point, okay, but it's about 3 inches deep. It's inside, in the center. So just with a couple of fingertips, doesn't matter which, just press in to that point. In Japanese, it's called the tanden, and it's on this center line that we set up, center of the head, center of the chest, center of the body. Just pressing in there. So if we're going to divide the body in half in all its planes, this is the place where they will meet. It's the exact physical central point of the body, and it's also the energetic sort of center. So So just kind of wake it up now, and then come to lie back, okay? Draw your knees in, hug your knees, coming into that unborn child position again. So we've got it all drawn in. If you can, lift your forehead to meet your knees. If that's a bit much, then you can let your head hang back. But just feel how everything's drawn in. Feel how you're like a seed. You're like a potential here. Okay, you're in that sort of wintry quality of not yet manifesting, of things just beginning to, as it were, draw in. Now, you may notice in this position that very naturally things center on that tendon point. That's sort of where we're going to start from. Okay, and now gently let your head go back, let your shoulders go back. Let your soles of your feet come together. So it's like the seed is just beginning to crack now. Let the soles of the feet come together. Let the knees come wide. And if you can, draw your hands around the feet or around the ankles. And just very gently drawing the feet in, pressing the knees wide. Just beginning again to sort of wake things up. Just gently, gently breathing, opening. One more breath. Good, and now separating your feet, let your feet come up to face the ceiling now, taking your hands onto your insteps. It's like the seed is just beginning to open a little more. That's it, good, and then gently drawing your feet down towards the floor. Now you may find you can let your head come back here, your shoulders back, or maybe not. And again, it's easy to force, and that's setting body against the mind. What we want is to kind of ease into everything. That's it, one more breath. Good, and now release your left foot. Let your left foot plant down. Begin to extend into your right. Link your fingers behind your right knee, behind your shin, behind your ankle. That's it. So the seed is just beginning to wake up again, coming into a little bit more life again. The first shoot, if you like, beginning to extend. Easy, easy. Good. And let this foot come down. And now reversing, extending up into the left. Fingers behind the knee, behind the shin, behind the ankle. That's it. Breathing, extending, waking up. And one more breath. Okay. And now let the knee bend on this side, linking your fingers around your knee, extending into your right heel. And if you can, come up into sitting or come round sideways if you wish, just coming upright. So things beginning to kind of wake up, they're beginning to move. Okay, so now in this position, you may find you can come over onto your hands and onto your knees or come round sideways so that you've got your spine parallel to the floor, hands beneath your shoulders, knees beneath your hips, okay? Looking down that space between your hands. But just for a moment, glance at the screen. So now as we inhale in this position, imagine the breath flowing up through the center of the spine to the crown of the head, breathing through the nose if you can, and then breathing out down the front of the body. So you've got a loop. Inhale up the back, exhale down the front. We're just going to do three breaths here in this position. So now inhaling up the back and exhaling down the front. And inhaling up the back and exhaling down the front. And one more time, inhaling up the back, exhaling down the front. And now building on this, as we inhale up the back, pressing the mid-spine to the ceiling, drop your head, drop your tail. And as we exhale down the front, reversing, lift your head, lift your tail, sink your mid-spine. Inhaling up the back and exhaling down the front. Inhaling up the back, that's right, and exhaling down the front. One more time. Inhaling up the back and exhaling down the front. Good. Now back to the center. Now walk your hands about one hand's length forward. So the heel of your hand is where the fingertips were before. And now as we inhale up the back, we're sinking the tail towards the heels, the forehead down to the mat. And then as we exhale down the front, drop the hips, come forward. Now keep it smooth, gentle, flowing. Inhaling up the back here and exhaling down the front. That's right. And inhaling up the back, exhaling down the front. One last time. Inhaling up the back, exhaling down the front. Okay, and now back to the center. And now walk your hands back, so hands beneath your shoulders again. Now tuck your toes under and then extend your heels down, your tailbones up towards the ceiling. Now, in this position, we're going to inhale up the back and then drop your knees at any point you wish. Let the elbows bend, brush your mat with your nose, come forward and up. You can have your knees down at any time. Take it as gently as is right for you. Inhaling up the back and exhaling down the front. Okay, and inhaling up the back and exhaling down the front. And one last time. Inhaling up the back and exhaling down the front. And now coming back to the center, begin to walk your feet in and towards your hands. Push forward through your knees and roll up into an upright position, into a standing position here. Okay, so having your feet, your knees, your hips, your shoulders all in line. So now we've got blizzards forecast. Apparently it's going to be a very, very wintry week ahead, at least the London forecast is saying that. If you're further north, you might be in it already. Now in Japan, in my experience, in the temples, they're very keen to, particularly in winter, get any cold out of the joints. You don't want to have cold trapped in the joints. So I want to take you through a little sequence that kind of mobilizes the body, and you may well find you get little cold shivers as the cold releases. Okay, and we're going to count, and we're going to count in Japanese. Okay, 1 to 10. So quick lesson in counting. So with your microphone off, let's see if we can do together. So 1 to 5 is ich, ni, san, shi, go. Okay, let's try together. Ich, ni, san, shi, go. And again, ich, ni, san, shi, go. Now, the reason we found it's worth hanging on to the Japanese counting here is because what we're going to be doing with each number is kind of pulling the belly in. So we're going to go ich, ni, san, shi, go. And there's somehow the sounds work well with that. Okay, so each one, pull the belly in. It's almost like we're activating the belly. Okay, ready? Here we go. And ich, ni, san, shi, go. Okay, with the belly. And one more time. Ich, ni, san, shi, go. Okay, and let's carry on. So it goes rock, shich, hach, ku, ju. Okay, and again, rock, shich, hach, ku, ju. Let's try together. Rock, shich, hach, ku, ju. And I'm bringing that belly pull in. And rock, shich, hach, ku, ju. Okay, one more time. Rock, shich, hach, ku, ju. Okay, so now let's see if we can do the whole lot. So we're going to start with ich. Each time, pulling the belly in with each number. Ich, ni, san, shi, go, rock, shich, hach, ku, ju. All right, so we're going to do it a few times. You'll kind of get it as we go. So we're going to start with the shoulders. We're going to go up, back, down as we count. Keep the belly active as we go. So good breath in and ich, ni, san, shi, go, rock, shich, hach, ku, ju. Go on, I got an immediate cold shiver. I don't know about you. Okay, so now up, forward, down. Good breath in and ich, ni, san, shi, go, rock, shich, hach, ku, ju. Link your fingers together, have your elbows in and together, and we circle in the wrist. So the elbows are going up and down against each other. Good breath in and itch, ni, san, shi, go, ruk, shich, hatch, ku, ju. That's it. And then reversing in your interlink. And then we're going to reverse in your circle. Good breath in and itch, ni, san, shi, go, ruk, shich, hatch, ku, ju. Okay. And now with your neck, we're going to open things up. Imagine you've got a marker pen on the tip of your nose and drawing circles with this pen. Okay. So you've got a board in front of you. Good breath in and itch, ni, san, shi, go, ruk, shich, hatch, ku, ju. Okay, and reversing. Good breath in and itch, ni, san, shi, go, ruk, shich, hatch, ku, ju. Okay, good. And then move your attention to your toes and your ankles. Take a kind of a half a step back on your right foot. So you're on your toes like this. We're going to circle in the ankle and kind of move into the toes, massaging into the toes. Okay, so good breath in and itch, ni, san, shi, go, ruk, shich, hatch, ku, ju. And reversing. Good breath in and itch, ni, san, shi, go, ruk, shich, hatch, ku, ju. Okay, and now reversing, stepping back on the left, into the toes, into the ankle. Good breath and itch, ni, san, shi, go, ruk, shich, hatch, ku, ju. And reversing, good breath in and itch, ni, san, shi, go, ruk, shich, hatch, ku, ju. Feet come together now. Let the knees bend. Hands come onto your knees. Okay, and then we're going to circle in the knees. So good breath in and itch, ni, san, shi, go, ruk, shich, hatch, ku, ju. And reversing. Good breath in and itch, ni, san, shi, go, ruk, shich, hatch, ku, ju. Okay, coming up. Now step your feet about hip width apart again. Hands onto your hips. Okay, and now move your hips forward to the left, backwards to the right. So we're going to circle in the hips. Now you may feel the whole upper body can become part of this movement, or maybe not, just as is right for you. So good breath in and itch, ni, san, shi, go, ruk, shich, hatch. Keep the belly working. Ku, ju. Okay, and reversing. Good breath in and itch, ni, san, shi, go, ruk, shich, hatch, ku, ju. All right, good. Coming up. And now, if you shift your body weight to your right foot and let the body swing to the left. Okay, so the left heel comes up, the body swings to the right, left heel comes up, and then we reverse, shifting the body weight across, back heel comes up, swinging left and right. So good breath in and itch, ni, san, shi, go, ruk, shich, hatch, ku, ju. All right, so now this time of year, we're working with the energy of the water system. We'll look at this at the moment, in a moment, but primarily we're working with the organs of the kidneys, which are right here. Okay, so now when we're going to do that same move again, but with your rear hand, let it kind of, if you can, come back onto your kidney area. Front hand, come onto that belly area that we've been sort of emphasizing. So swinging left, swinging right, kind of like that. Okay, so good breath in and itch, ni, san, Shi, go, rock, shich, hatch, ku, ju, and one last time, ich, ni, san, shi, go, rock, shich, hatch, ku, ju. Excellent, good. Coming back to the center, feet, knees, hips, shoulders, all in line. Center of your head, center of your heart, center of your belly, all lined up that way. Shoulders down away from your ears. Let your eyes soften and lower just for one breath. And just bring this quality of mindfulness to the body. Just sensing where for you is already alive, flowing, free, dynamic. Where is there still some more waking up to happen for you? Zen Master Hakuin, an important teacher in our background, says, Buddhas are like water and ordinary people are like ice. So our job is to, as it were, melt the ice. So when you come across any area that's tight or closed or clenched, frozen within you, simply allow the sunlight of your awareness to gently melt away just whatever you're finding there. No forcing. It's just a question of being there with what is. And the ice becomes water. What is locked becomes free. Gently, gently. So, in this winter season, we're working with the water, appropriately enough, the water element within the body. So we want the water to be free and flowing and not frozen. Now, the organs of the water element are the kidneys we just mentioned and the bladder, appropriately enough. And we have energy lines on the front and the rear of the body, which are connected with these organ systems that we'll be activating with our movement work. So first of all, if you can bend forward, and there's a spot right here, right in the middle of the foot, just below where the balls of the feet are, okay, called the bubbling spring. Now, this is where our kidney point starts. So if you bend forward, find how your knees bent, just reach under the feet, okay, find that spot, okay, just press in just a little bit, just wake it up, middle finger maybe. Okay, now from here, we're going to trace our kidney line up the insides of the legs, okay, and then over the front of the trunk, right up towards the collarbones, left and right of the sternum. Okay, so the kidney energy line is kind of moving upwards through the front of the body. And then the bladder line, the reverse line, which is also important this time of year, we start the crooks of the eyes, the inner corners of the eyes, over the head, tracing left and right of the neck vertebrae. That's it, left and right of the spinal vertebrae, over the middle of the glutes, and then straight down the backs of the legs to the outsides of the feet. So when we combine these together, we basically have a sort of a loop, kind of flowing up the front and flowing down the back. And so let's just trace this out now, just using the palm of your hand with the lightest touch that you can manage so that it's still discernible or feelable, but there's no pressing in, okay? So we're gonna tuck your chin, roll your spine forward, come into the that middle of the foot, and then rolling the spine up with a really light touch, coming up, 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 hands coming up, 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 front of the body, over the head. That's a really light touch. Tuck your chin, roll your spine forward again, and we come all the way down again. So with a flow. So now maybe connecting with the breath, inhale, rolling the spine up, smooth, feeling your way as we come up over the head. That's it. Tuck your chin, rolling your spine down again. Really light touch, waking up your mindfulness of sensations. One last time. Inhaling, coming up, chin tucked. So spine coming up, up, up. That's it. Over the head. Exhale, flowing down the back. Rolling down, 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 down. That's it. All the way down. Now, once you're down here, stay down. Okay. Draw your hands to the front of your feet now. If you can, lift your feet, tuck your middle finger underneath all your fingers, but your middle finger finding that kidney point. Press in, if you can, with your middle finger. Now, it's fine to have the knees bent here. Begin to lift the tailbones. Begin to tuck your chin, coming into a kind of a gentle fold. That whole bladder energy line on the rear side of the body being invited to open, to extend. Now, your mindfulness of the body, your mindfulness of sensations, is kind of scanning through the body, sensing for any places of tightness, resistance, just letting that sunlight of your awareness begin to melt away any tightnesses. Anything that seems to be resistant, that's nearly always a sign to just back off just a tiny bit. We're easing into this. If we try to force things, the body locks. Good. Now on an inhale, straighten your arms. Let the knees bend. Now you may find you can come down into a squat with the heels down. You may find the heels lift. Front body is long, just for one breath. And now on our next inhale, we're going to come up again. That's it. So same again. Just particularly drawing your attention to the rear sides of the body, the backs of the legs, the glute area, left and right of the spine, the neck, just finding a gentle, pleasurable stretch sensation here. The body, the mind, working together in union, in a condition of yoga, rather than the body being forced by the mind. Good. And now on your next exhale, tailbone down towards the floor, front body long. That's it. Chin tucked. And one last time on your next inhale, coming up again. That's it. Gently folding, easing into this. The sunlight of your awareness, turning the ice into water, gradually, gently, easing, inviting. Good. Now, inhale, push your knees forward. Release your hands and begin to roll up, coming up, up, up into an upright kind of position. That's it. Okay. Coming all the way up. Eyes closed, just one breath. Just feeling into your body now. Where is it starting to wake up, to zing, to flow right now? Where is it not yet like this? Where is there still more to come for you? Letting your eyes lift and now stepping your feet wide, roughly one leg length wide. So you've got an equilateral triangle shape between your legs. Have your heels turned out just a touch more than your toes. So your second finger is, your second toe is straight. Okay, the knees are soft. You're not locking back in the knees. Find the hinge right at the top of the leg, this diagonal hinge. Okay, and then we're going to fold forward at that hinge point, making the hands into a loose fist now and resting them on the kidney. So come forward into the position where you're like a tabletop. Your chin is tucked, your spine is long, and now putting a strong rub into your kidney areas. The kidneys hate getting cold, and this time of year, they really appreciate a bit of extra heat. So 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, good. Now put the palms of your hands on the kidneys so you're trapping that heat into the kidney area and now beginning to fold forward. Your tailbone's lifting towards the ceiling. That's it. Gently easing into this. Good. Again, what we're looking for is that pleasurable stretch sensation. No forcing. Tailbone's lifting. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. Now from here, let just your left hand come down to the mat in between your feet. That's it, roughly in line with your chest. Good. Let the elbow be bent, if you can, on the left elbow. Right hand stays on the right kidney, and are beginning to turn your chest up towards the ceiling. So you're still folding forward, but you're just turning your head, your chest, kind of moving from the chest, if you can, turning up. Breathing, turning, and 5, 4, easing into it, 3, 2,
One, good. Gently back to the center. And now left hand on your left kidney, right hand in the center. That's it. And now turning, breathing, lower elbow bent. That's it. Chin tucked. And five, four, three, two, one. Good. And gently coming back again. Both hands onto the kidneys. That's it. Now engage the front body. So come back to that tabletop position, chin tucked. And then inhaling, coming up, coming all the way up into an uprightness. And now from here, turning your feet out just a little bit left and right. And let the knees begin to bend. So it's like we're sitting down into this position. Now what we're not doing here is kind of that, sticking the bum out. Okay, so the pelvis stays square. We've still got the head, center of the head, center of the heart, center of the belly, all in line. We're just sitting down into this. Now look down, make sure you can see your at least your big toe inside your knees. If you're losing track of your toes, if your knees are flopping in, they kind of push wide. So we're kind of beginning to wake up this kidney line on the insides of the legs. Let the hands come together into a prayer position. Now push up towards the ceiling, let the elbows bend and your thumbs come and meet the back of your head, the back of your neck, between your shoulders, wherever's good for you. So you've got your knees moving down and out. You've got your elbows moving up and out. That's it. Now, if you can, look up a little bit above your eye level, but keep your chin tucked so you'll feel this upper part of the kidney energy lines also come into focus here. Knees wide, that's it. Breathing, just inviting things to open here. And five, four, three, two, one. Now keeping in this position, think about the center of your chest as leading the way. We're going to go over towards the right knee, circle across the center, the chest leading the way, and circling up again. So we're going to do three circles, going around, down, to the left, and up. One more. That's it. Around, down, left. Coming up, and then we're going to reverse, okay? So coming over to the left. That's it. Keep sinking into your tail as much as you can. Think about your knees working wide. That's it. Second one. Very good. And last one. Gently coming up, coming out of it. Now inhale, extending through your arms, through your legs. Exhale, coming down and come back to your neutral position, feet about hip width apart, body upright, eyes just lowered, just for one breath, just sensing for you. How can you feel within your body? Sensing the aliveness, sensing also the places where there isn't full aliveness yet, where there's still more to come for you. Eyes gently lifting now, and inhale, extend your arms in line with your shoulders, back of your neck long, and then exhale, let the knees bend, come down, 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 down. If you need to put your fingertips on the floor, go right ahead. If you don't, that's great. And then coming down into a sitting position. Okay, so in this position, have your knees a little bit bent like this. Okay, your feet can be on the floor. Now, we've got the thighs here forming a kind of a landing strip. Let your belly come forward to your thighs. Now, if you need to bend a little bit more for that to connect, or a little bit less, that's fine. But what we do now is we draw the forearms in and below the knees. So we're locking the belly and the thighs together. We've got the back of the neck long. Okay. So what we're going to do now is we're going to keep this binding and begin to let the toes come towards the ceiling and begin to extend into the legs. Good. When we're working like this, we're kind of putting the emphasis on the bladder energy lines and particularly the upper part, the areas around the glutes, the lower spine, the left and right of your main spinal length, possibly even into your neck, into your head, finding again a gentle pleasurable stretch sensation. So this is an invitation rather than a coercion. Okay, gently easing, inviting the body to lengthen into this. And five,
4, 3, 2, 1. Very good. And now releasing through your hands.
That's it. Coming up, gently drawing down. And now let your hands come down to the floor like this, left and right. Press down through your hands. Or you can have a loose fist like this, if that's easier for you. Press down through your feet. Press up as much as you can through the midsection of your body. Now you can keep your chin tucked, or you can let your head hang back, just as is right for you. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And now let your tail come down to your mat again. Now toes pointing towards the ceiling. We're sitting upright here. And now from here, reaching forward in line with your shoulders. Now imagine your fingertips are going to touch the opposite wall. So we're not going to go down, we're going to go forward, all right? Maybe in only a tiny way. But what this is going to do is bring the attention more into the legs, from the heels into the glutes, into the hamstrings. So begin to reach forward, chin tucked, so body stays upright, just gently inviting this lower part of the bladder energy line to come into focus, and just sensing what you can feel, sensing where potentially you can begin to melt the ice here. That's it. And 5, shoulders down away from your ears. 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. And gently coming out of it. Hands plant down again, or loose fists as you had before. Let the knees bend this time. Let the hips come up. And now this time, if you wish, pointing the right big toe. So knees stay in line with each other, hips stay lifted. Now, if that's a bit much, it's fine to keep both feet down, okay? Your priority is your hips, your chest. You can hang your head back or tuck your chin. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. Let the foot come down. Let your tail come down. Extend into your heels. That's it. Have a little shake in your elbows and wrists if you wish. Sit tall. Inhale. We're going to combine what we did before, back of the neck long. And now exhale, come forward. Hands landing on your feet, your ankle, your shins, wherever's good for you. Tuck your chin. Think about the crown of your head moving towards your big toe. Finding a sense of a gentle, easy, natural quality of stretch here. Easing into this, back of the neck long. That's it. So the whole bladder energy line from the inner corners of your eyes all the way down into the feet. Just invited to engage here. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Very good. And inhale, coming up, shoulders down, arms lifting away. And now on your exhale, plant your hands down again. Plant your feet down again. Hips come up. That's it. And now this time, pointing, if it's appropriate for you, your left big toe. So extending through the left leg. If that's a bit much, it's fine to keep both feet down. Chin tucked or head hanging back, as is right for you. That's it. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. Feet come down, tail comes down. Have a little shake through your elbows, through your wrists. Just getting everything loose and free. Good stuff. And now from here, extending through your right leg, and let your left knee come out to the side, this kind of position here. Have your left heel as high up the straight leg as is appropriate for you, and line up the center of your chest along your straight leg. Okay, so my teacher in Japan, Zen Master Shinzen, he would do this almost every day. And we're going to be working we've got the kidney line on this side, we've got the bladder line on this side. So gently walking the hands forward, either beside or on this leg. Now I said, gently come forward, crown of the head pointing towards your second toe, and then put a little kind of rock into it, like we're rocking the body a little bit left and right. He would do this almost every day, this kind of easy rocking sensation, almost like we're treating the body like a baby that's kind of being soothed.
side to side, no jerkiness, and maintaining this quality of respectfulness, this quality of attention, this quality of mindfulness. Couple more breaths. Excellent. Coming back to the center, and now beginning to straighten through your arms, and now just the right hand coming onto your foot here, your ankle, your shin, wherever's good for you. Now you may find you can tuck your elbow inside the knee, or just on, that's as is right for you. Now draw your shoulders now, so they're one on top of the other. Reach up towards the ceiling with your left hand. Look up. Good. And now still looking up, keeping the shoulders as they are, let the left hand come over. Now it may connect with the right, or maybe in above the right. That's totally fine. Looking up. That's it. Easing into this. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. And now inhale, come up. Let the knee bend on the straight leg. First two fingers around the big toe. Make a circle with your thumb, your first finger on the left. That's it. Let your feet and your hand be up, shoulders down, looking over towards your circle. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. And gently come back to the center, planting that foot down. And now we're going to reverse. So we're going to extend forward through the left leg. Let the right heel come up as high as is good for you. Sitting tall, center of your chest, lining up along your straight leg, and then walking your hands forward here, finding a gentle, easy quality of stretch. Good. And now from here, tuck your chin, crown of the head, pointing towards your big toe, and put a little bit of a rock left and right here. And that's it. Just gently easing in, just letting things hang out here, maintaining your presence, your awareness, your mindfulness, the sunlight of your attention beginning to melt away the ice. Gently easing into this left and right. That's right. And now coming up a little bit, straightening in your arms, and now just the left hand anchoring on your foot, your ankle, your shin, your big toe, wherever's good for you. Right hand extending up to the ceiling. So again, shoulders one on top of the other, look up, and then reaching over wherever that right hand wants to go. But the priority is your shoulders staying one on top of the other. That's it. Breathing, opening, and 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. And inhaling, gently coming up, coming out of it here, bending the knee so that you can get a good grip around the big toe. Make a circle with the right hand. That's it. Looking up towards your circle, drop your shoulders away from your ears. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. Now let the knee bend. Let the soles of the feet come to meet each other here. Let the knees come wide. Now, first of all, have your feet forward so you've got roughly a diamond shape in between your legs. Front body long, sitting tall, link your fingers together. And then on your exhale, let your hands come forward over your feet. Begin to press into your elbows. Think about your forehead moving towards your feet here. Find a gentle, easy quality of stretch. That's it. Breathing, opening. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. And now inhale, gently coming up, drawing your heels in towards your body. Now, for many of us, we've got quite a bit of tightness on the inside of the legs, so the knees tend to be up because we don't spend a lot of time on the floor, really. Now, what the scientists have discovered and the yoga people have discovered experientially over the centuries is if you work a muscle and then go into your stretch, you get a deeper stretch than if you go into what's called a passive stretch. So we're going to activate these adductor muscles, as they call the muscles on the insides of the legs that draw your legs together, okay, before we stretch them. So if you can tuck your elbows inside your knees, let your hands come into a prayer position, and what we're going to do is we're going to squeeze in through the knees, okay, so you'll feel the muscles here activating before we do our stretch. Now, before we go into that, just also become aware you've got opposite muscles on the outsides of the legs, and the body is designed so that if you work the opposite muscle, then its partner tends to release. So we're going to be using that in a moment too. But first of all, we're going to activate the insides of the legs. We're going to activate here the adductor muscles. So pressing the knees in, feeling that sort of work in the muscles, squeezing, and 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good, and release. Good. Now let your hands come down onto your ankles. So thumbs onto your ankle bones and hands over the top. Once you've found your ankle bones, now roughly 3 fingers width above the ankle bone, on the bone there, is a point, a very important point on the kidney energy system. Now it's a little bit more tender than the surroundings. It's fairly easy to find. If you're not finding it, don't worry too much. Just sort of press into the general area. Now, I'm told that you don't want to be pressing this one if you're heavily pregnant, all right? Apparently, it can bring on things a little bit sooner. But otherwise, just press into this point, elbows down and out, activate the muscles on the outsides of the legs now, which are going to be drawing your knees down towards the floor. Come forward, front of the chest is long, chin is tucked, kind of easing your knees down towards the floor, feeling that gentle, easy quality of stretch through the adductors, through the insides of the legs. That's it, easing into this, and 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good, and now gently come up. Okay, knees stay wide. Now right hand comes around onto your right kidney. Left hand comes around onto your left knee, onto your right knee, shoulders down, back long, chin tucked, and now beginning to turn the body, beginning to rotate the body. That's it, breathing, turning, and 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good, and now reversing. So we've got the left hand on the left kidney, right hand on the left knee, shoulders down. That's it, breathing, turning, and 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good, now coming back to the center, reaching in between your legs. First 2 fingers around your big toes. Shoulders down, chest up, floating your feet away from the floor. So there's a little bit of space between your feet and the floor. Now look up a little bit above your eye level. Find a spot to fix your eyes on if you can. Now you may find you can begin to straighten your legs here. If that's a bit much, it's fine to keep them down just as far as is good for you. You can come into land if you need to at any point. But if you can, beginning to extend into your heels, shoulders down away from your ears, your spine long, and 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And now beginning to extend left and right into your heels, your shoulders down, that's it, your spine long, breathing, and 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good, and gently coming in, coming all the way out of it. Soles of the feet come in together again. Okay, and now from here, gently walking your hands back. So you've got your hands behind you. Again, we can have loose fists or fingers pointing back. Press down through your hands, down through your feet, pressing wide through your knees. Begin to let the hips lift. Now you can look up towards the ceiling or hang your head back, your choice. Breathing, lifting, and 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good, and now let your tail come down towards your mat. That's it. Good. Let your hands come around your knees, drawing your knees in, and now beginning to kind of flop your knees just a little bit left and right, just loose and free through your knees. Just easy, easy. Have a little shake in your elbows, in your wrists, and then coming into a cross-legged position. Letting your eyes soften and lower. Just one breath. And now just tuning in, sensing for you. How is the aliveness in your body right now? Where are things starting to zing, starting to flow, starting to come alive? Where is there still more to come for you? Just sensing how it is. Eyes gently opening. Good. And now from here, let your knees begin to separate again and the soles of the feet come together like this. Okay. And then from here, begin to roll your spine all the way down and let your hands come to meet above your crown. So you've got your palms together, your feet together. Now, in this position, your lower back tends to arch away from the floor. Explore what needs to happen for your lower spine to really press into the floor. That anchoring into the floor through the lower spine is going to activate your belly here, wake things up in the belly, and it's kind of the center of this move. So now keeping that pressure, that connection, lower spine and floor, on your inhale, let your hands, your head, your shoulders begin to lift, if it's appropriate. Just lifting as is right for you. Now, weirdly enough, if you lift a long way, it's often easier than if you just lift a little bit. But just finding for you the right level of challenge. Chin tucked, that's it, pressing through the lower spine. And five, four, three, two, one. Head comes down, hands come down, that's it, breathing. Lower spine still pressing into the floor. And on your next inhale, we're going to keep the lower spine pressing down, the head and hands staying down, but this time the feet beginning to lift away. Again, you can choose the level, lifting a long way, lifting a little way, just the right level of challenge for you. And five, four, lower spine is the core, the key of the move. Three, two, one, good, feet come down again, just letting it all release, letting it all whoosh. And on our next inhale, we're going to let the hands, the head, the shoulders come up. We're going to let the feet come up, just if that's right for you, chin tucked. And five, four, three, your priority, still your lower spine. Two, one, good, feet come down, hands come down. Head comes down. Now reaching around, let your knees come in and towards the center, like this. Very good. Let your knees come up. Hug your knees, just for a moment, linking your fingers around your right knee, extending into your left heel, and now gently floating up, coming up into sitting. Okay, coming towards the front of your mat. Having your feet together here, your knees together here, palms facing each other. And now, this time, no hands. Let your feet float away from the floor. That's it. Now, again, you can keep the knees bent. If you wish, you can begin to extend into your legs, just as is right for you. Breathing. And five, four, three, two, one, good. And now from here, let the hands come down, the elbows come down beside you. Let the head and shoulders go back and let the feet come over the head. Now, you may find for you, you want to have your feet pressing towards the ceiling. That's great. You may find the feet want to come over the head. You may find they want to come over towards the floor, just wherever is right for you, only as far as is appropriate for you. Breathing. That's it. Now, don't move your head here. Let the body kind of ease into it. Gravity doing the work. Your job is to surrender, to allow, to be present with what's happening. If it feels good, you're in a good place. And five, four,
3, 2, 1. Good. And inhale, letting your feet come over your head. That's it, all the way over and down to your mat. And now let the knees come wide, so you've got the soles of your feet together again. You're down to the mat. And now lift your tail just a little bit. Hands come beneath you. So you've got your kind of wrists beneath your glutes. Okay, now roll your body a little bit side to side to tuck your elbows in. Now, actually, before we go any further, if you can turn and look at the screen, okay, and let me show you, because that you won't have a line of sight when we're in position. So from here, our job is to press into the elbows, sliding the head in towards you, so the head doesn't lift. We're looking towards the back of the room, the chest is lifting to the ceiling, and then we come out of it by sliding the head again along your mat. So the head stays along the mat at all points, so you're not compromising the neck in any way. Okay, so coming into position, elbows beneath you as much as you can, your wrists beneath your glutes, knees wide. Begin to press into your elbows, begin to lift your chest towards the ceiling, gently sliding your head in towards you, just as far as is appropriate for you. Front body long, and 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good, and gently coming out of it again. Now releasing through your wrists, through your elbows. Turn your head a little bit side to side, making sure everything's loose and free through your head, through your neck. Let your knees come in and together, okay, in this kind of position. Let your arms come wide in line with your chest. And now let your knees come over to the right. That's it. And then top foot across your center line towards the left hand. Your shoulders down. That's it. Good. Breathing, looking right. Good. Breathing, easing into this. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now knees come together, feet come together, and now coming in across your center line, knees coming over to the left, looking to the right, if that's good for you. That's it. And then top foot across your center line towards the left hand, your shoulders down. That's it. Good. Breathing, looking right. Good. Breathing, easing into this. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now knees come together, feet come together, and now coming in towards the center. Lifting your right knee, linking your fingers around your right knee, extending into your left heel, and floating up. Now if that's a bit much, come up sideways. Coming to the end of your mat, or where you've got some space behind you, having your knees wide, hands around the ankles. Now, one of our sort of famous figures in Japan is called Daruma. This is a Daruma right here. I'll just bring him in close to the screen. Okay, so Daruma, he is a very symbolic representation of the person who brought Zen from India to China. And he went on retreat for 9 years in a cave. I've been there. And this is a Japanese version where he's a kind of now in a doll form where he rolls, but he always comes up again. The motto that he's got associated with him is 7 times down, 8 times up. Whatever life's going to push at him, back he comes. And right now, we probably all need a bit of that resilience. So we're going to do this Daruma move. Okay, so in this position, hands around your ankles, come forward, gently, gently forward. And now as you inhale, we're going to roll back along the spine and then coming up again. Okay, so as we have with Daruma, nanakorobi ya oki, 7 times down, 8 times up. That's it. Okay, breathing, just rolling, massaging, releasing
along the length of your spine, only going as far back as is appropriate for you here. Just kind of gently waking things up, easing things through your spine. Massaging, releasing in your spine. That's it, good. Gently breathing. Okay, and once you've done your seven times down, your eight times up, then coming into this uprightness through your body, okay? So kind of where we started. Now it's fine to kneel, it's fine to sit, just whatever's comfortable for you. Take your right hand, put it on your belly, your left hand, the palm on your back, kind of directly behind, almost as if your palms are connected. Okay, and then we're going to do 21 times a strong rub, okay, circling up, round and down. Okay, so good breath in and push in, really a strong rub, 21 times. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. Okay, and then reversing. So left hand in front, right hand behind, strong rub, good breath in, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. Very good. And then make your hands into loose fists, lean forward a little bit, drawing your hands onto your kidney area. And now 21 times here, strong rub. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. All right, good. So now from here, if you'd be willing to come and lie back on your mat, but do what you need to do to maintain the heat within your body. So if you want to put on some extra clothes now, some socks on, put a top on, put a towel over you or a blanket, just whatever's going to maintain that heat that you've kind of generated in your practice. And now come to lie back. So you've got your legs out straight, your feet falling out to the sides, your hands, if you can, on your belly, and your elbows on the floor. Now, if your elbows won't land, then it's fine to have your hands beside you. But if you can, having your hands on your belly, lengthening through your spine. Some people like to have a thin cushion or a paperback book, something small beneath the head. Some people just lie straight back, just as is going to be right for you. Okay, so adjusting your body, lengthening through your spine, letting your shoulders release down into the floor, letting your hips release down into the floor, getting warm, getting comfortable, letting your eyes lower and soften. And when you're kind of ready to enter stillness, letting your eyes begin to close. So we have, just as we started, we've got the head, the heart, and the belly aligned. Like Zen Master Basso, we came into stillness, we came into alignment, and then we moved from here. And now we're returning to this centering again. And it's so strongly emphasized in our school of Zen that we have these two phases, stillness and action, stillness and action. And so now as we come back into stillness, we're also coming back into release. We've been melting the ice through our action. Now our job is to allow things to begin to flow. And the more you relax, very naturally, the more things can ease and flow. So just exploring how it might be for you.
to release and relax all the little muscles around your eyes. And releasing all the little muscles between your eyes. Sensing what you can feel. Releasing all the little muscles over your forehead, around your ears, around your mouth, your jaw. Releasing all the little muscles over your scalp. And down through your neck, your shoulders, down through your arms, your wrists, all the way down, even into your palms, the backs of your hands, your fingers. How would it be for you to release all the little muscles in your whole body? How would it be for you if you could just allow yourself to reap the benefits of all the engagement that you've applied? How would it be if you could allow yourself to begin to float? The more you can allow yourself to float right now, the more you'll find yourself able to float through the rest of the day. Releasing into your natural flow. You've done your work. Now just letting it happen. And just sensing what you can feel. Allowing. Enjoying, coming home, when we come into this condition, where body, mind, you and the whole universe come together. The old teachings of Zen tell us we come into a place where you have no problems. You're home. This moment, this alignment, this reality is full. You and the entire universe are one thing. You have it all, and you are it all. And just letting yourself be here. Letting yourself come home.
allowing yourself to restore, to recharge, to renew, all the way from the center of your being, all the way out to the edges of your body, all the way out into your fingers, your toes, gently beginning to move into your fingers, gently beginning to move into your toes. And that's it. And when you're ready, coming over onto your right side, just relaxing, staying in your natural flow on your right side. And gently, smoothly coming up into sitting or kneeling, whatever's upright and poised and comfortable for you. Drawing your hands together, we offer the merit of our practice for the benefit of all living things. May all beings be well. May all beings be happy. May all beings find liberation. And then gently warming your hands together, just rubbing them together. That's it. And then sharing a little bit of this warmth with your eyes. That's it. Just gently holding your hands over your eyes. And then with your fingertips, gently tapping over your forehead, over your crown, the back of your head, your neck, your shoulders, your body. And just sensing again how you can feel. And when you're ready, allowing your eyes to gently lift. All right, well, thank you so much for coming down. So now, with this kind of practice, it really works best if you do a little bit of homework. And if you can, maybe a couple of times a week, maybe a little more if you can manage, if you can just do some practice by yourself and just, you know, allow the body to ease in and open into these things, bring that non-judgmental, non-coercive presence into the body, just do a little bit, a little bit, a little bit, then that'll have your body in great shape. Number one thing with all of this is, if you can treat the body as a source of wisdom, the body knows what it needs. So in so much of the sort of physical culture elements in the world, there's a quality of pushing, forcing, no pain, no gain. This is not at all like this. This is much more about allowing what the body needs to, as it were, lead the way. And what we find is, as we deal with the mindfulness of the body and the mindfulness of the sensations, then strangely enough, the other two elements that the Buddha stresses, mindfulness of the mind or the consciousness, and then mindfulness of mind objects, what's happening within the consciousness, they tend to straighten out too. The beautiful thing about this, these four elements of mindfulness, the body, the sensations, the mind or the consciousness, and the mind objects, is the Buddha himself teaches, if we deal with any one of them, we deal with all four. So the body is a wonderful vehicle for finding peace, not only within the body itself, but within the mind as well. So please, you know, treat your body as this source of wisdom. How can Zenways help you? Five ways. Number one, subscribe and hit the notification bell here on our YouTube channel. We've got new videos every week. Number two, get a hold of a copy of Practical Zen. This is our main practice manual, particularly building a foundation around 100 days of continuous practice in our style. Number three, you can become a Zenways member. It's free. It's all based on donations. We have a thriving worldwide community of practitioners, activities and events, both online and live. Number four, we have a series of retreats. Particularly, I'd like to recommend our Breakthrough to Zen retreats. Again, all based on donations, no charge. Again, online and live, and very much geared towards helping you get your first step in the world of enlightenment. And then number five, if you're interested in doing an externally validated professional training with us, you can become a meditation and mindfulness teacher, and you can become a yoga teacher. All the information on zenways.org.